Morning. I'm Ben Shapiro. I'm on the DNDI board. Just want to say a few words to welcome you today to the second day of what's a really remarkable event. Yesterday, we were exposed to a range of intellectual and emotional ideas, contributions about the profundity of the challenges that we're trying to face here. And so we heard from physicians and other healthcare providers who were thrown back into the 1920s, essentially, in the pre-antibiotic era, in having to give imperfect and toxic products to people to treat them for serious infectious diseases because these people had been neglected and these diseases neglected despite the enormous advances in biomedical research that occurred over that almost century. And the frustration is magnified because we recognize that 20 and 30 years ago, when we were watching our friends and family members and loved ones die of a viral infection, when there were very few antiviral drugs of any type available and none for HIV, that we could watch a pharmaceutical industry take on the challenge with academic researchers and physicians worldwide, and really dig into this with appropriate investment and intensity to actually change the course of what seemed like an impossible challenge to come up with true antiviral therapy for a serious disease and replace the immune system back to its normal function and allow people to live normally. So that we know that these advances in biomedical research are not just theoretical, but they are practical and they can be implemented. And thus, we wonder why they can't be implemented for patients who have been neglected with diseases that are no more challenging, in fact. And today, we're going to look at several of these issues to dig more into the coloration and the complexity of what we're talking about. But what we're really talking about and what was emphasized yesterday was that if we start from a position of patients first, and we realize that there is an enormous amount of science and intelligence that we can apply to this, and we also recognize that it's not only a technical issue of coming up with the right tools or right drugs or correct vaccines, but it's a whole structural issue of how to get these to the person who really needs them. If we can bring all that, if we can actually focus on the nature and complexity of the fatal imbalance, that we really can make a difference. And so we've seen over the past 10 years that there actually have been improvements. That by, just in the, you know, I can speak most clearly about DNDI, just in focusing on the patient, we could come up with six new therapies that would change the course of those people's lives. We're not talking about some vague sense of entities of people around. We're talking about individuals who are sick and dying of diseases, and there have already been opportunities to change that equation. But we know that we have not come anywhere close to the penicillin equivalent, the game changer that was described yesterday by several people, that we've diagnosed the problem. And we started to come up with some early therapies to deal with it because we focus on patient first. But we also recognize that with our pipelines full of new entities that we might come up with the appropriate molecular entities in the next several years to approach these diseases. But because of the complexity, and I think that coloration is going to come out in this panel today, because of that, we need many other actors to buy into this and to work together to do it. The molecule is not the answer. It's a molecule coupled to a whole different way of looking at neglected people and thinking about what their needs are. And so many players have to engage, and certainly this is a global challenge and requires a global response. And we hope that those of you who are so committed to this and are here because you're so committed to this can think in those terms that we need molecular answers, but we also need structural answers. And today, I think you'll understand why for all of these three very important areas, all of those are needed, but that there is hope. because science has advanced so much that there's no reason why we can't apply the best science in the world for these neglected patients. So thanks for coming here and for listening to all of this and participating in it.